I would say inherent in August Wilson's work, in Intozaki Shange's work, in Lorraine Hansberry's work, and in Marcus Gardley's work is spirituality. It's a common thread that I could see running through all of their works. And it isn't always expressed explicitly, but it's there. Mm-hmm. And I like that. Yeah. I like that a lot.
With August Wilson, you know, I always call him the master poet. And what he was able to do is he put poetry on stage that not only sounded like everyday language, but proved that these people did speak in poetry. And he, you know, he's quoted often for saying, "I just let them talk." He really did let them speak. Because I think before August Wilson arrived and his work arrived on the American stage, African Americans really didn't just talk. I mean, we did speak, but we didn't have, there wasn't a platform just to really speak. And because we have 10 plays, you know, the 10th century cycle, you really get a chance to hear a breath of a community, because of course all this place takes place in the same neighborhood. So you really hear 100 years of beautiful poetry from a community. And I really try to apply that type of poetic landscape in my work. I'm a big advocate of poetry in the tongue, but poetry that is pushed so it's not so musical that it lulls you to sleep, but it is charged so that it keeps you on the edge of your seat. And that's what I'm really excited about. And he has really been a major mentor in my life. Lorraine Hansberry, I think she was she is the foremost playwright that really got to the heart of community. All her work is about community and about family and really dealing with those issues that most people want to turn away from. You know, people, I know now Raising in the Sun is a classic, but when that play first came out, you know, it was controversial. And she was really talking about, you know, women being independent and being doctors and the matriarch of the family and the dynamics of the family and who we are as African American people and what we deserved, where we deserve to be, and our dreams, you know, the dream deferred. Our dreams don't have to be deferred. We should go out and get them. So I'm really, really a big advocate of her work, and she's also a major mentor. And Intozaki Shange, you know, I've been reading a lot of her work recently because I reread For Color Girls. I wanted to read it before I saw the movie so it could be in my heart when I saw the movie. But I loved it again so much that I read a lot of her other work as well. And I think she is just so phenomenal. Her voice is really, really powerful. And what she's able to do, even on some level, even greater than August with poetry, is really, really inspiring. I think she, to me, has tapped into the African-American female voice, but all colored women, their voice in such a unique way that it's no wonder that piece lives on decades after it was produced on Broadway. And my dream is to at least touch, you know, the poetic landscape that she has created in her work. So I'm a huge fan.